Ramona here from RamonaRemeset.com with the weekly oracle card reading, and my apologies, I know that I'm getting this reading out to you guys a little bit late. Lately I've just had so much going on that I was feeling rather burnt out, so I decided to honor that and head away into the mountains for a few days to recharge my batteries, and I feel so much better. And in fact, I am writing about that this week in my e-zine with some instructions for people on how they can better recharge their batteries and just honor themselves and take time out for self-care. So if you're interested in that and you would like to read that, you can sign up to get on my e-zine list at RamonaRemeset.com. You'll see the address coming up at the end of this video, so be sure to go there. And you can also grab my brand new three-part video series, which is entitled The Three Essential Steps to Getting Anything You Want in Life. So that is a really, really, really handy tool to have. I would encourage you definitely to go onto my new website to add your name and email there so you can get your hands on that right away. All right, so before we get into the reading, this will be the reading for the week of October 27th through to November 2nd. Already we're heading into November. The weather is starting to tank here in Calgary. This morning was very chilly, lots of frost out, drinking lots of tea. Look at the mug my family got me for my birthday. All you need is tea and warm socks. That's pretty much sums it up, what keeps me going through the winters here. So yes, we are flying by with this year. So let's see what's up for this week. Okay, and I'm working with the angel therapy. Oops, I guess I go this way. The angel therapy cards this week. So as always, I'm going to draw the three cards that we need for the week. I've asked the angels, the archangels, to bring through the messages loud and clear for the highest good of all, and to help me get my ego out of the way so I can bring through these messages clearly and accurately. Okay, so we're going to have that one for the beginning of the week. This one will be for the middle of the week. And one more will be, no, you know what? That one wants to be for the end of the week. Okay, let's see what we have. Nice. This is very timely, very interesting. It says, visualize success. And I'll read you the message. It's saying, see yourself doing well in this situation and have faith in a positive outcome. This is specifically for Monday and Tuesday. So if there's something you're a little bit nervous about, you're not sure about, use the technique of visualization to get a clear, crisp picture in your mind of how you want that situation to unfold, of what you want that to look like. There is a lot to be said for visualization. In fact, that is one of the things that I talk about in my new video series that I mentioned earlier. So if you want to get the full instructions on how to work with visualization, what it means, what it does, more of the nitty-gritty, be sure you go, like I said, to my website, RamonaRemeset.com. Enter your name and email there on the homepage, and you're going to get that video series and you'll get that information on how to work more specifically with this tool. All right, but especially for Monday, Tuesday, you know, like I said, if there's something you're not sure about, you're feeling anxious about, you're nervous about, or even just a situation in general that is not going the way that you had hoped it would go, rather than dwelling on that not so great way that it's going, turn that around. Close your eyes. Take a few minutes to breathe deeply and envision what that situation would look like in its most perfect scenario for you, okay? And try to get it so crystal clear in your mind. It's almost like you're in a movie, like you can just be in that moment, okay? So that's what is a great thing for you to do for Monday and Tuesday. Into the middle of the week, we have indigo, and you've probably heard me talk about that terminology before. I'll just read you what it says on the card. The person you're inquiring about is an indigo, meaning a highly sensitive, natural-born leader. So in the middle of the week, Wednesday, Thursday, you might be encountering people who are very results-driven, or they're very much a doer, but they also don't follow the rules. They really like to kind of break out of the rules. They kind of break down established stuff, but they're supposed to. That's their job as an indigo. An indigo is here as a change bringer. Somebody who is meant to break down the establishment to create way for new things, because the way a lot of what we're doing right now is really not working. It's not, you know, for our highest good. Things like governments, things like, you know, finances and things like that. So anyhow, indigos are here. They are doers. They are very much all about making change. But because of that, some people can perceive them as being rather difficult at times. So if you're encountering some difficulty with people in the middle of the week, step back and see if maybe there's a deeper understanding or deeper reason for that. It could be that's part of their spiritual job on Earth at this time, that they are meant to do those things. It just might give you new insights to why they are being the way that they are. And if you have a child that exhibits some of these characteristics, it can be difficult as a parent, you know, if you have an indigo child. So there's some resources out there. I would encourage you to look some of those up. One great one is by Doreen Virtue. It's called The Care and Feeding of Indigo Children. So check that out. You know, if this is a new term to you, you might want to research that. And a lot of children that have been diagnosed with things like attention deficit issues are often indigos, okay? They get mistakenly diagnosed, you know, and then they may be put on medications and things like that. It makes them withdraw, it makes them shut down from who they really are and the job that they have in this life. So that might be something, like I said, you want to research, okay? And it might even be yourself. It could be you exhibiting some of those characteristics. So think about that. And as we head into the weekend, we have parents. So we have parents, and the message on this card says, the divine truth is that your parents eternally love you to the best of their ability. The angels are helping you heal from any pain associated with your mother and father. So, you know, a lot of times things happen when we're, you know, through the course of our childhood into our young adult years, parents say things, they do things. And it's not that they're trying to be, you know, malicious in what they're saying or doing. It's that they're doing the best they can with what they know in that moment. And you know, it's hard though, because once words come out of somebody's mouth, those words can't be taken back. So they can be hurtful sometimes. Some people are having a lot of pain associated and maybe resentment or anger issues relating to parents. So if that's the case, just know that they truly do love you in their own way, even if that seems very dysfunctional or not the way that you think a parent should show love. But really you want to do some forgiveness work around that, because when you hold on to anger, hold on to resentment, you're really only harming yourself. And there's that saying that holding on to anger is like drinking poison and expecting the other person to die. So really it is about the harm that you are doing to yourself by holding on to those feelings, or maybe stuffing those feelings, you know, not having a healthy outlet to deal with them. So some healthy techniques that you can try to release that is to maybe write a letter, not necessarily with the intention of ever sending it, but as a way of getting those feelings out so you're not stuffing down. When we stuff our feelings and we don't have a healthy way of dealing with them, it creates dis-ease in the body. And if you leave that unchecked, it can manifest physically into disease. You don't want that to happen, right? So definitely have a healthier outlet for your feelings. You know, and writing is a really great way to get that out, you know. Don't be stuffing it down. Get that out. You can also do some forgiveness work. You know, picture them in your mind's eye and say, I forgive you and I release you. I hold no unforgiveness back. And now you are free and I am free. And really feel that. And you might have to go through that a few times. But that is also a great way to let go of some of that resentment that you might be holding on to. So that is some homework that you can try into the weekend. So overall, another great week. We have working with that visualization. Super, super powerful technique, you guys, okay? Spiritual tools are not difficult. They are simple, but if you use them correctly, they are extremely powerful. So I do encourage you all to work with visualization. Okay, in the middle of the week, we have, again, the indigo. If you're dealing with somebody difficult, if it's a child, if you're exhibiting some of those characteristics, look that up. The more understanding that you have around what an indigo person is, means, and does, the better it is for you to understand that and to kind of understand what's going on. And then if you have some issues that you've been holding on to surrounding your parents, this is the weekend, maybe the time now, to deal with some of that, especially before we head into the busy holiday season, right? You know, in the U.S., you're going to be having your Thanksgiving, we're going to be celebrating Christmas, there's Hanukkah, there's other festivals, Diwali is going on right now. So all of that, you know, you often are around family, and if there's harboring of resentment and things like that, it can make family gatherings very difficult. So don't carry this forward, you know, into this holiday season, and then the calendar is going to roll over and a whole new year is going to start again. Let's clean that up right now. So do some of that work this weekend, okay? So thank you so much again for watching. As I said, if you want to get your hands on the 3 essential steps to getting anything you want in life, you know, get over to my brand new website, ramonaremesat.com. Fill in your name and email there. You'll see the little box to put that in. You'll also get my e-zine so that this week you'll get the article that I'm putting out all about how to take better self-care, how to honor your feelings when you're feeling burnt out and all of that stuff. All right, so have a great week, everybody. Stay warm. Tea, warm socks, works great. And we'll see you here next week. Thanks.